changed for everyone.
Caring, sharing, volunteerism.
Inclusive, community, together.
Compassionate, responsive, essential.
Supportive, contribution, advocate.
Inclusive, dignity, elevate.
Compassionate, caring, inclusive.
Essential for community.
Professionalism, success, help.
Acceptance, support, education.
Gracious, integrity, unifying.
Care, community, support.
Caledon community service is very good.
Generosity, donors, Caledon community.
Caring with heart.
Connection, community, family.
Passionate, focused, responsive.
Passionate, respectful, and inspirational.
CCS, connecting, uplifting, community.
Essential, respectful, thankful.
Engaging, encouraging, amazing.
Best community care.
Passionate, purposeful, family.
Supportive, innovative, and kindness.
Serving community, caring.
Compassionate, helping, empowering.
Inclusive, dedicated, and reputable.
Teamwork, teaching, integrity.
Strong, compassionate, interested.
Leaders, dedicated, reliable.
CCS means to us compassion, community, and
caring.
Open, honest, nurturing.
Inclusive, tenacious, and loyal.
Caring, helpful, community.
Driven, dynamic, fun.
Clients come first.
Helpful, community, resilience.
Collaborative, authentic, and innovative.
Teamwork, happiness, teaching.
CCS cares for us.
Goodness, fun, teaching.
Integration, engagement, support.
Compassionate, community, empowerment.
Engaged, responsive, and essential. That's CCS.
Caring, compassionate, service.
Inclusive, engaging, grateful.
Compassionate, inclusive, community.
Community, hope, and action.
Thank you.
live from Caledon, literally home for the holidays. Brought to you by the good folks at Caledon Community Services. And right now, here are your co-hosts for this virtual extravaganza, Joanna Downey and Stephen Julian.
Perfect, 6 feet.
Sounds good. Let's get this party started.
Masks off. Welcome to the 23rd annual Home for the Holidays Gala.
Literally home for the holidays.
I'm Joanna Downey, the gala chair, and this is my co-chair, Stephen Julian. Hold on. Selfie time.
Peace on earth.
Please send us your pictures tonight using hashtag Gala, CCS Gala 2020. We hope to share them later on.
We thank you for choosing to spend another evening in front of a screen. We are extremely grateful that you have chosen our screen tonight, and we hope you're enjoying the beautiful baskets so carefully assembled by our gala volunteers. Joanna, you look beautiful tonight. I have to say, you look like $1 billion.
Why, thank you, Stephen. You look like $1 million yourself.
I may look like $1 million, but I actually got this from Evolve Clothing, so it's $475 plus tax.
Amazing. Are you nervous tonight, Stephen?
A little bit. Did you think we'd have a 30-page script?
No, but it says right here, we'll be fine. We can read it word for word.
Oh, perfect.
So, Stephen, one of the traditions in my family at this time of year is reading classic stories and poems. I have one to share with you right now. Want to join me?
Absolutely.
"'Twas the night before gala, and all through the town, not a creature was stirring, no one made a sound."
'Cause you're all on mute.
"Although the stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that the gala soon would be there, the committee still wondered as they lay in their beds, with visions of
fundraising dancing in their heads.
With Stephen in his tux,
$475,
and I in my gown, we just poured a glass and started the round. When out in the distance arose such a clatter, we sprang from our seats to see what was the matter. Away to the router we flew like a flash drive, reset the password and opened the
Zoom meeting,
hoping to catch a special guest in his holiday greeting. When what to our wondering eyes should appear but a team of volunteers with smiles ear to ear. With Denise and Vicky so lively and quick, we knew in a moment they would do the trick. Corbin, our guy, Lynette and Jackie, this is our crew.
We're all a little bit wacky.
Faster than reindeers, the Angelas and Tracys came and they worked.
If the gala was live, they would have twerked.
Darlene and Sabrina, Sally Ann and Joyce, the committee is stacked.
CCS rejoice.
So up to the housetops, the coursers they flew with a sleigh full of baskets. Zaba, Carmen.
Ashley and Nicole too.
To the top of the town, to the top of the wine wall. They've given their best. Now it's time for a rest. And we heard them exclaim as they drove out of sight,
happy gala to all, and to all a good night.
Thanks for joining me in that story, Stephen.
That was beautiful, Joanna. We thank you for choosing to spend another... So in years past, our gala guests would have arrived at the gala, enjoyed a signature cocktail, made their way through the silent auction and Christmas market. Use your imagination. Wine wall over there, truffle boxes over there, and of course, if you're one of the board members, you'd already be at the antipasto bar.
This year, we arranged for an online auction through MobileBid, which I hope many of you have already logged on to and are starting to bid generously to our donated items. If not, I encourage you to take your eyes from the screen just for a moment and pick up your phones and text H4HGALA to the number at the bottom of your screen. It's so easy. I'm bidding on the flying lessons right now.
Joanna, this phone is cordless, but I can't figure out how to text. Can you bid on those Caledon East auction items?
I got you covered. No worries.
Thank you.
Anyway, like many of us, you've been connected to CCS for many years, and we're very familiar with our services and how we work in the community. For those who don't know CCS well, stay tuned as we look forward to sharing messages, stories, and even a virtual tour tonight.
Oh, wow. And of course, we are very grateful to our local artists, Ethan Luce and Jessica Sewell, for joining us this evening to entertain you throughout our time together.
To kick off our evening, I'd like to introduce a guest that Caledon folks will know very well, bringing greetings from his living room, Mayor Alan Thompson and his lovely wife, Anne. I believe they've been enjoying some local treats.
Hello, everybody. Yeah. Anne and I are here tonight celebrating Home for the Holidays with CCS. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we're sitting here by the tree. This looks much different this year than it has many others. But this year is why CCS Home for the Holidays is extremely important. More than ever, we got a lot of families out there that need a lot of help. And it's very important that we support this event every way we know how. Like the changes that we have here. Normally every year for Christmas, you bring your daughter and everybody together and you do a lot of baking and make a lot of cookies mm-hmm. for things to hand out. But this year we've reached out to the local
Just
businesses.
The two of us.
And here's what we've got. Check out the gingerbread man.
Yes, so what we did is we've supported some of our local businesses to pick up some cookies for our cookie treats this year. And so Joanne and Stephen, it's our gift to you to share with your special guest tonight. And I want to say a special call out to both of you for your hard work of what you're doing tonight, for the work that your whole team, because I know it's an entire team, and I know it's a lot of work. And it is important work. So I thank you. And while we're talking about CCS, honey, this is our Christmas tree that now graces our living room. We actually picked that up at the CCS auction a couple of years ago as part of the designer program designed by Jackie Vienne, a very talented local woman in our community. So it's part of our new traditions with this new tree. And we've got some great cookies from different bakeries across town. And Joanna and Stephen, I'm hoping that your special guest will enjoy a plate of cookies tonight.
Really? Home for the holidays, everybody.
Enjoy. Literally, home.
Wow, thank you, Mayor Thompson and Anne, for that beautiful message and these beautiful cookies. We really want to thank you for your continued support of CCS. We really appreciate you.
Someone's calling.
What? CCS Gala, literally home for the holidays. What's that? Oh, hey, Kirk, how you doing? I'm great, thank you. Are you enjoying the gala? You're able to log on? Good stuff. Oh, wow, he just came in at a sponsor
That's
level.
That's amazing.
Nice.
Thanks,
really?
Kirk.
No way. You know his dinner jacket.
The famous gala jacket?
He said he'd trade it straight up for a Mark Grice print.
Amazing. Let's get this done.
Wow, thanks for your continued support, Kirk. We really appreciate you. Take care.
Amazing. I can't believe he's going to give you the famous gala jacket.
Wild, wild.
At this time, we'd like to take a moment to recognize our amazing sponsors, with whom we would never be able to host an event such as this. It is because of your generosity and amazing support that we can do what we do for the community. Our bold sponsors this year: Yorkwood Homes and Laurier Homes, RGF and Mattamy Homes, Ultra Store and Argo Development Corp. Our silver sponsors, Fieldgate Developments and James Dick Construction Limited. Our bronze sponsors, Brampton Brick, Guglietti Brothers Investments, Paradise Developments, Peel Police Services Board.
We're gonna fix this white shirt problem right now.
Our supporters, Brandon Steele, Brookfield Residential, Caledon Hills Private Wealth, Paulus Wealth, Glenn Schnarr and Associates Incorporated, Silco Tech, Town of Caledon, and last but not least, our matching sponsor, Scotiabank. Let's take a moment to thank all of our fantastic sponsors who have made this possible this evening. Your outreach and continued support of our community allows us to do what we can do and to continue serving our clients. Let's hear from a couple of those sponsors now.
Hi, I'm Steve Silverberg from Cedar City Developments. I work with Yorkwood Homes and Laurier Homes in Mayfield West. I've been working on projects in the town of Caledon for over 10 years, and it's always great to learn more about the whole community. We are proud to be sponsors of this event for several years, and it's heartwarming to see all of the hard work that the folks from Caledon Community Services do and all the great programs that they've put together. Especially in these times, the need for help is greater. More reason to reach out and do whatever it is you can. I wanted to wish everybody the best and a safe and healthy holiday season, and all the best of luck to Caledon Community Services and this great event that they've put together. Enjoy.
Coming in hot. Look at that jacket. I can't believe it. Amazing.
So we couldn't get a hold of Mark Grice, but he said I could borrow it for the rest of the gala.
That's a pretty good trade up.
Sweet. So, Joanna, a tradition in my house is playing games over the holidays. In honor of the late great Canadian Alex Trebek, rest in peace, we'd like to pay homage to him tonight and play a little trivia game with all of you. Take a look at your screens and play along with us.
What's the first question, Stephen?
During the holiday season, Canadians spend millions of dollars on this plant. What plant is it, and where did it originate from? A, mistletoe, Canada. B, Christmas tree, USA. C, poinsettia, Mexico. Or D, juniper, England.
Don't forget to hit submit when you answer the question. Are the results in, Stephen?
Oh, everybody knew that one.
The answer is C. The poinsettia is native to the area in southern Mexico, brought to USA in 1828 by Joel Roberts Poinsett.
Perfect. Second question. When was the first Home for the Holidays gala held? A, 1972. B, 1982. C, 1998. Or D, 2001?
I don't know if anyone will get this one.
This is kind of hard, actually.
It's a bit of a trick question.
Oh, it's a split.
Interesting. Well, everyone, the first Home for the Holidays gala was held in 1998.
Wow.
23 years ago.
Wow, that long ago.
23rd annual.
Awesome. Third question. What other campaign is held by Caledon Community Services during the holiday season? A, Kids in Caledon. B, Seniors in Transportation. C, Santa Fun. Or D, Holly Jolly Christmas?
I'm sure our local Caledon residents will know the answer to this one.
They must know this one. Yep. Everyone knew that one. CCS is doing a good job.
The Santa Fund was started in 1982 to provide toys and support to families during the holiday season. It is run from mid-November to the new year. This year, due to COVID-19, we are encouraging monetary donations and gift cards.
Beautiful. Number four, what holiday became popular after it was featured on a popular sitcom? A, Christmas. B, Kwanzaa. C, Diwali. D, Festivus. Or E, Hanukkah. Oh, you're giving it away.
I think our organizers are helping out our guests here.
Yeah, everybody got it.
100%?
One of my favorite episodes.
Of course, Festivus. Dan O'Keefe coined the holiday Festivus. His son, a writer on Seinfeld, used what was their family tradition for one of their episodes. This day is now celebrated on December 23rd. Time to air some grievances, Stephen?
Absolutely. Number five, what was the original name of Caledon Community Services when it was founded way back in 1971? A, Caledon Information Center. B, Caledon Information and Community Services. C, Bolton Contact Center. Or D, Caledon Community Services. I think this could be a hard one.
It's a bit tricky. And why so many name changes?
No, they didn't get it.
Well, 4 out of 5. Caledon Community Services was founded in 1971 as the Bolton Contact Center, providing a crisis line and some informal supports since the agency had 3 name changes before settling on its current name. In 1983, the agency became Caledon Information Center. In 1991, the name changed to Caledon Information and Community Services. And in 1998, CCS began to operate under the name Caledon Community Services. In 2021, CCS will be celebrating 50 years. How awesome is that?
Wow, 50 years is a big milestone for sure. Thanks for playing our game, everyone. Hope you learned a bit. Now a break to hear from our sponsors.
For some entertainment, our first performer is a talented and up-and-coming artist. Ethan Luce grew up in the Dufferin-Caledon community and graduated from our local school, Robert F. Hall. We are thrilled to welcome him as one of our featured artists to our first ever virtual stage.
Hi, my name is Ethan Luce, and I'm super excited to be here to perform a few songs for you guys. And I want to say thank you to CCS for organizing this wonderful virtual gala, and for everything they do for the Caledon community and the families that live in it. So thank you. Here's a few songs. It's not really a Christmas song. It's more of a summer song, but here we go. It's been a hell of a ride. Yeah. Your father, he loved to be bothered. Go and treat your partner. They're always working so hard. And go party with the homies, cause holy, it has been some time. Yeah, so go and get your mother, tell her you love her. Go and hug your sister, God knows you missed her. Go and squeeze your brother, cause it's been a hell of a ride. Yeah, and go and see your father, he'd love to be bothered. Go and treat your partner, they're always working so hard. And go party with the homies, cause holy, it has been some time. Yeah. Christmas, like the ones I used to know, where treetops glisten and children listen to hear the sleigh bells in the snow. Yeah, I've been dreaming of a white Christmas. Every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white, cause you're always smooth as Tennessee whiskey, you're always sweet. Strawberry wine, you're always warm as a glass of brandy, and I stay stoned on your love all the time. I used to look for love in all the same old faces. I found the bottom of the bottle dry. When you pulled out your heart, I didn't waste it, cause there's nothing like your love to get me high, cause you're always smooth, it's Tennessee whiskey, you're always sweet as strawberry wine, you're always warm. It's a glass of brandy, and there's nothing like your love to get me high. Oh, cause I've been dreaming of a white Christmas. It's like the ones I used to know.
Wow, thank you so much, Ethan. That was a beautiful performance. Now I'd like to welcome Monty Laskin, CEO of Caledon Community Services, with a special message followed by some words from some more of our sponsors.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Monty Laskin, the CEO of Caledon Community Services, and I am so pleased to have you with us this evening at the first ever Literally Home for the Holidays Gala. I hope you're comfortable and having a wonderful dinner at home along with many others across Caledon. In many ways, we really are together tonight. We would have loved nothing more than to have brought us together in person, celebrating a great community, but 2020 had other plans. The Friends of CCS have pulled this virtual gala together. Way back in July, they said the show must go on, and that it has. Our volunteer committee, co-chaired by Joanna Downey and Stephen Julian, they flipped the switch and they created a plan to celebrate and raise funds this evening for important community services. Alongside them, the entire CCS organization has been tireless in the past months, ensuring that everyone needing help receives it, that none of our neighbors get left behind. As so many of us were forced to close our doors, CCS figured out new ways of reaching out to our community. Our buses still drove people to their essential appointments. Our seniors continued to receive personal support services. Our jobs and newcomer clients moved online for their training. And everyone seeking emergency food and utility supports were provided for. CCS stepped up through an exceptional staff team, one that I'm very proud to be part of. At the end of the day, we couldn't have done it without you, our valued and loyal donors. Tonight, as we come together to celebrate community support, I raise my glass to all of you. A toast to all of you, our magnificent and generous donors and supporters. Thank you. Thank you for being here this evening and for your unwavering generosity. Your kindness is changing the lives of so many people in Caledon. Tonight, I wish you and your families the very, very best of the holiday season. I'm close to draining my glass, the first one. Who's driving these days? It's time for a refill. Stay healthy and stay well, everyone. Merry Christmas and happiest of holidays to you all.
Building neighborhoods since 1978 means over 40 years of move-in days, of ball games, of housewarmings, and get-togethers. And those 40 years have taught us, when a community comes together, we'll always find a way.
Hello, everyone. My name is Tim Warner, and on behalf of Mattamy Homes, I would like to wish you and your families a safe, healthy, and magical holiday season. Happy holidays, everyone.
Nice jammies, Monty. And thanks again to all of our sponsors. It is now my pleasure to introduce members of the team, the backbone of CCS, the esteemed program directors of Community Resources, Employment and Training, and Health Services.
I'm so excited to be joining you for the Literally Home for the Holidays Gala. This year has been a particularly difficult year for families accessing services in the Exchange Community Supports Program. Families who were already struggling with basic needs were forced to also deal with the compound effects of COVID-19. I'm very proud to be part of an agency that responded so quickly to the changing needs of the community as a result of the pandemic. At the Exchange, we quickly modified services and without interruption have been able to continue to provide thousands of grocery hampers, gift cards, basic needs support, and care and counseling to those families in greatest need. All of these vital supports could not have been provided without your help. Our donors and partners are the true community builders in Caledon. On behalf of the hundreds of Caledon families who have accessed supports and all the Exchange staff and volunteers, we want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for helping us to respond to the vital needs in Caledon. We wish you a very happy and simply magical holiday season from our family to yours.
Hi everyone, I'm excited to be joining you tonight for the Literally Home for the Holidays Gala. There is no doubt that this year has been challenging for everyone, including our job seeker, youth, newcomer, and employer clients supported by the Employment and Training Division. The COVID-19 pandemic has forced the closure of many business activities and physical job sites, resulting in significant layoffs, labor market changes, and financial hardship. I have to tell you that I am so proud to be part of CCS, an organization that quickly adjusted services to ensure that all clients were supported. All employment and training services immediately pivoted to remote delivery. Workshops were developed to support the changing needs in the labor market. Language classes and settlement services expanded to include online delivery, while youth and employment programming adjusted to support skills development and changing employer needs. All of these critical supports could not have been provided without you, our donors and partners, our community champions. Grateful is the word that comes to mind. I thank you all and wish you a beautiful holiday season and a hopeful new year.
Hi, everybody. It's so nice to see you all this evening. Thank you so much for choosing to spend your time with us. The Health Services Division has been rocking the service delivery all throughout COVID, and we've been fearlessly going out, providing services face-to-face to seniors in the community. Know that your contribution and your support is vital to us. It ensures that no senior in Caledon is ever alone. Our services help people maintain their independence and ensure that their needs are seen and addressed. I want to thank you all tonight, and I want to encourage you to grab your wine, get your credit cards out, spend and contribute, because every dollar counts and every dollar helps the community get stronger. So with that, I wish you a great evening and happy holidays from all of us at CCS.
Thanks so much to the directors of CCS for all that you do to ensure the programs and services run smoothly. And before we move on, I just wanted to remind you about the silent auction.
Yeah, and it's so easy. Right here on your phone, mobile bid. There's lots of great items up for bid. So, so easy. It's better than shopping online.
Sweet.
Geraldine was right. It also gets better with wine.
Nice. Now, just before we introduce our next entertainer of the evening, a few words from our sponsors.
The James Dick family of companies is one of the leading independent aggregate and concrete producers in Southern Ontario. Aggregates are the raw materials that form the foundation of our society. Roads, schools, hospitals, and your home all are built with a form of aggregate excavated from a quarry or a gravel pit. Aggregates are an essential product. In fact, the average Ontarian consumes 14 tons of aggregate each year. The James Dick family has been in Caledon for 8 generations. James Dick started the company in 1964, building the company from the ground up.
It's now my pleasure to introduce our next performer to our virtual stage, Jessica Soule. Jessica Soule is a country musician and songwriter based out of the GTA. Jessica is a multi-instrumentalist and has received her bachelor's degree in music from Humber College, majoring in voice. As well as being a vocalist, Jessica is self-taught on guitar and piano.
So I'm going to start off with an original of mine. This first tune I'm going to play is called Think of Us. I wrote it a few weeks ago, and it's kind of like a happier spin on a breakup song instead of remembering all of the sad memories and all the reasons why you broke up in the first place. This one's more of like a looking back at the good memories and hoping that that person thinks of you sometimes and thinks of all the good memories you guys shared also. So I've been doing a lot of writing over quarantine and over the last few months, gearing up for our next project, so I hope that you enjoy Think of Us. I feel this fading with every text that you send. This ain't for saving, don't have the heart to pretend. No one to take the blame, guess life works out that way. Think of Us. This one's on my debut EP as a country artist called Here for the Long Run on all streaming services. And if you download the album or listen to it, you'll hear this next tune. So Fine Line by Jessica Soul. I hope that you enjoy it. Save me. so easy, but the way that I feel, that it's going straight to my head. Now I'm picturing you, and I'm picturing me, and I'm picturing all of the things in between. But there's a fine line between you and the whiskey.
Thank you so much, Jessica. We really appreciate you. That was a wonderful performance. Thank you for joining us tonight.
Stephen, did you know in 2013, CCS opened its doors to The Exchange, a true community hub that has a focus on nutritious food and community programs? They're designed to enrich our lives. The Exchange welcomes everyone in Caledon to share ideas, participate in activities, and get to know our neighbors. Let's take a walk through The Exchange together, and then we'll hear from our CCS board chair, Ian Armstrong.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to The Exchange. I hope you're enjoying Literally Home for the Holidays. We'd like to take you on a tour of The Exchange, so please follow me, and we'll go and see. We have over 10,000 visitors that come to The Exchange on a yearly basis. They're greeted at the front desk by one of our volunteers. Due to COVID, we have put some safety measures in. These are our counseling offices back here, and our care coordinators meet with families that are struggling to make ends meet. They help them to develop plans to improve the quality of life. Throughout the year, we could be helping anywhere from 250 to 300 families within our community, and at this time of the year, we tend to see more people come in. This is the pantry. This is where families come to do their shopping. They could pick and choose whatever they wanted off the shelf. Since COVID, though, we've had to prepackage the hampers in order to give out to the families. But we really do thank the community, because it's without them, we would not be able to have our shelves stocked as well as we do. One of the main focuses here at The Exchange is dealing with social isolation. The lounge is a great spot for that. Everybody is welcome to come here to have a cup of coffee. There's books, there's games, and it's just really a good spot to meet other people and enjoy each other's company. We host a lot of groups here at The Exchange, and a lot of them use the kitchen. The kitchen is a great spot for them to learn a new skill set of cooking, and at the same time, whatever they've made goes into the pantry to help feed the families. We also have client classes that teach other clients how to cook some of the regular food that they get from the pantry. Sorting area. This is where all the food comes in from the community. It's our volunteers that will be looking for dates, and if the cans are rusted, to be checking them out. We have Fines Ford coming in today, and they're the ones that go off to the schools to do the pickups for the food donations. Thank you guys for helping us out. This is the food that you see that has come in from Thanksgiving, and this will be the food that will be sorted next by the volunteers. We're standing here in the food storage area. This is the food that we put into the pantry as well as into the hampers for the families. We are currently going out to the community right now to get more resources, more food, because that will help us to feed the families into 2021. Thank you for joining us here at The Exchange. Most importantly, thank you for your support, and I want to wish you happy holidays.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ian Armstrong, the Chair of Caledon Community Services, and it's my pleasure to bring greetings from my board on this very special occasion. I'm standing in front of a cornfield which is about to be harvested, and I feel grateful that I have a job, and I know that when I get home, I'll be surrounded by family and friends, and there will be food on the table. Living in such a rich area, it's easy to assume that all of us are as fortunate. The funds raised at this virtual event go directly towards supporting our neighbors in need, whether it be emergency food support, jobs and skills training, transportation assistance, or even a helping hand and a listening ear. Your participation goes a long way. I want to thank you so much for your support of CCS by joining us on this first ever virtual gala, Literally Home for the Holidays. Please take the time to visit our online silent auction or to make a gift during our Gift from the Heart portion of the evening tonight. You can make a difference. Stay safe, stay well. Joanne and I are hoping that the disc jockey will be playing Cotton Eye Joe later. Have a happy holiday, everyone.
Wow, where did the time go? I can't believe the exchange has been open and serving Caledon families for 7 years, Kim. Kudos to you and your team. You've come a long way. So much has changed since my first visit back in 2013, before the doors were even open.
And Ian, we'll be sure to get your song on. Now, we'd like to take a moment to highlight some of our special auction items. If you are a lucky guest that has your basket and your program at home, let's roll through them together. Our three premium featured auction items start with a getaway for two. Sounds great, eh, Stephen?
Wow,
Hockley Valley?
Yeah.
Perfect package with a $100 gift card towards dinner at the cabin. Our second featured auction item is Cider Sunday. That would be an amazing thing to do with a bunch of friends.
If we could do it, I can't wait till we can do that again.
Absolutely. A great way to visit local cideries and breweries and take in all of the sights of Caledon. Our third auction item is Strike a Pose, generously donated photography set. Your family can take in the sights of Caledon, great locations.
Probably a little better than our selfie.
Probably. So our bids on those items go directly to our clients supporting CCS. All of your donations will go to the people that need it the most.
Hey, Joanna, since we're following some traditions tonight, I'd like to share some letters we have received from some of our wonderful clients. I'm hoping these letters will inspire all of our guests to make a gift from the heart tonight.
Get my big book.
To CCS and the Exchange, mine and my children's lives have suffered following a devastating and traumatic loss with the tragic passing of my husband and their dad. While it has been a most difficult time to reach out for assistance, I had to put my pride out of the way to allow for emotional and financial support for my well-being to heal. I always felt comfortable with your concern, kindness, and professionalism, and I just wanted to tell you that I appreciate it all. The life and grief counseling and the advice you offered has assisted me see my life in a new light to move forward. I look forward to the social workshops and stepping out of my box. The pantry and hamper service has been wonderful and allow for me to stay within my tight budget. I am ever so grateful. Thanks for being there.
Stephen, isn't it amazing to hear from our clients and how the support that they get at CCS is truly helping them?
This is why we do what we do, Joanna. The exchange at CCS has been a blessing to my family. I signed up with the exchange after my husband's long battle with cancer. My husband and I had to put our careers on hold to deal with the cancer diagnosis and continuous treatment. I can truly say that we would not be able to deal with the hardship if it wasn't for the support of the exchange staff. Coral, our counselor, has helped us every step of the way, whether it was to help find programs that can help us, or in-house programs like food support, providing school supplies, or gift cards so we can buy things we need in this difficult time. I don't know what my family and I would do without your help. Thank you.
Stephen, I love hearing the clients say great things about the wonderful staff that we have at CCS. They truly make the difference.
They're amazing at the exchange. I love them. Transportation. Dear Caledon Community Services, I wanted to send a quick note of thanks for playing a huge role in my family's world. We are longtime Bolton residents, and both my parents were active members of the community. When my brother Giuseppe, better known as Pepe, and I lost them both within years of one another, we were at a loss. Well, I was at a loss. You see, it's just my brother and I. My brother is a middle-aged man with special needs. I had no clue how I was going to get my brother to his programs, let alone run my own day-to-day family obligations. Enter CCS. Thankfully, this service has allowed both my brother and I to continue with our day-to-day lives without interruption. The most valuable detail in all of this is the peace of mind I have knowing my brother is not just getting out to the programs he thrives on, but to know he is taken care of. And when I say that, they may not know it, but CCS looks out for my brother, and I couldn't ask for more than that. For those that run the transportation division, from the office to those out driving, I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I hope you all know what an amazing team you are, and without your service, I know personally my brother and I would be lost. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Sincerely, Michelle.
These letters from our friends and neighbors in the community really underline the difference just a small bit of added support can make in someone's life. This is why we do what we do, and we couldn't do it without you. And we couldn't do it without your ongoing support. So please, go and grab your basket. Find your white pledge envelope. Save the red tickets for later. So far, this event has raised $97,000.
Wow, we are so close to our goal of $100,000. That's so exciting.
And it's so easy. Help us get there. Go online.
Feed a family. Provide a ride.
Choose a one-time or monthly gift.
CCS needs your support now more than ever.
When you give to charities, how much money actually goes to the people that need it most? At CCS, it's a question we answer every day. This is our home. And right here at home, we have people with real challenges. And they're struggling. The thing is, they might be hiding in plain sight. It can be your friend, your neighbor, or even your relative. Someone you love. It's taking care of the ones who took care of us, and it's bringing a smile to the ones we love. When you see someone in need, you have a choice. You do. You can walk right past them. It's easy to do. You can say, it's not my fault, it's their problem. But for us, there is no choice. You look that person in the eye and you pick them up. Now, you may not know this, but there are hundreds of children right here in Caledon who rely on CCS for something to eat. That's not right. So when you ask us where the money actually goes, we're happy to tell you. It went to the 5,000 times someone needed our counseling services last year, or the 37,000 rides we provided to seniors and those with disabilities. It went to providing 170,000 pounds of food for the needy, or the 9,500 times families in need turned to the exchange for something to eat. It went to job training and a sense of dignity for the disabled. It went to 350 community workshops and hundreds of volunteers who spent 30,000 hours helping people with clothing or heat or a helping hand. It went to 600 pounds of fresh produce we were able to grow for the Exchange Food Support Program, and 2,000 people that we helped find work because living in a car should never be an option. We've all been in need at one time in our life, and when that day comes, Caledon Community Services will be there. So when you ask where your money goes, it goes to helping people like this, and this, and this. People like your neighbor, your teacher, your mother, your daughter. And someday, it might even be you.
Thanks so much to all our guests for their generosity. Please remember that any amount you can give is more than we could count on before tonight. Whether it be $5, $50, $500, it all makes a difference.
Absolutely, Stephen. And I'd like to remind all of those bidders out there that the auction closes at 10 p.m.
What's that?
Do you hear that? I think our special guest is here. Now I'd like to welcome our special guest that we've been patiently waiting for. Can you guess who it is?
Ho, ho, ho!
Santa!
Merry Christmas.
Oh,
wow. Merry Christmas, Joanna.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Whoa, Santa, 6 feet away.
I am 6 feet away from you, Stephen.
Okay, okay.
Have a seat, Santa.
Merry
Join
Christmas.
Us.
Ho, ho, ho.
We're so happy you could make it. We have cookies for you, Steve.
Stephen's stealing the cookies again. Merry Christmas.
Can I hold that for you, Santa?
Sure, that's the naughty and nice list.
Oh, really? And who's on this list?
Well, 99% of the people tonight involved are on the nice list. There's one individual who's on the naughty list, as usual, every year. Stephen, where are you? Stealing my cookies again. Oh, wow.
Well, Santa, I'm glad that you could come. Everyone is really happy that you're here with us tonight, and I hope that you can help me draw some prize tickets tonight.
I'd love to.
We've got lots of people at home watching, and they've got their red raffle tickets in their baskets. So, Santa, if you'd like to pull a few, we can read the numbers. Oh. And everyone watching, if your number is pulled, write it in the chat box below.
There you go.
Our first winner, drum roll, number 484533. Remember, write your name in the chat box. All right, Santa, next winner.
Whoops.
Not
that
two
was
at a
no
time.
Good. There we go.
Perfect. Our next winner, 484530. Don't forget, write your name in the chat box. All right, Santa, one more.
One more.
Third winner, 484444. Get that name in the chat box. Can you repeat the number? Sure, I can repeat the numbers.
There is one more.
Wait, you have one more, Santa?
There's a special one.
A special
this
gift.
This is from Santa.
And what might it be?
On the night of the 22nd, Santa will visit this winning ticket's house.
So Santa, you're going to go to this house?
I'm going to go to their house. I will social distance. I will wear a mask. And I will visit the family that has this ticket.
That's amazing. Thank you so much, Santa.
These are stuck together.
That is okay. We'll take the top number.
Alrighty.
And the winning number for Santa's visit on December 22nd, socially distanced visit, 484399. Remember, your tickets are in your pledge envelope inside your basket. And I'll read these numbers one more time just to make sure everybody got them. First ticket, 484530. Our second ticket, 484533. Third winner, 484444. And our special donated on the spot by Santa himself, 484399. We'll be sure to get in touch with all of our winners shortly. Now, Santa, we have one more.
One more.
This is a really special one.
This is
our farm-to-table dinner, generously donated by Campbell's Cross Farm and Chef Michael Gallo. So, Santa, if you can reach in here, mix those up, and pick one more so we can announce the special winner right here tonight. Where's that drum roll?
There we go.
And the winner is Philip Hodgson. Fantastic.
Great.
You're gonna love this experience. So fantastic. Santa, thank you so much for your help in being here with us tonight to help us raise funds for CCS.
It was a pleasure. It's a great cause. Please pledge as much as you can. $5, $10, $50, as much as you can. It's a great cause. This year it's needed more than ever. So please support, help. And just before I go, I just wanna make a quick announcement. Stephen, no more cookies for you. And I want to remind all the boys and girls and mums and dads out there, 19 more sleeps till Christmas. That's it.
I'm excited.
You got to start behaving. Boys and girls, listen to your mums and dads. But most important this year, moms, dads, boys, and girls, social distance, wash your hands, wear your masks, and most of all, everybody, have a very, very Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Thank you so much, Santa. Thank you for the Core Four. Always close to my heart.
It was an experience.
Have a safe trip back to the North
Pole.
I
will, and I'll say hello to Mrs. Claus for everybody.
Thank you.
Except for Stephen.
Of course. Take care, Santa.
He's never not been on the naughty list. Have a very Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, everyone.
Bye, ho, Santa. Ho, ho. So I've just heard from Santa's elves that so far tonight, we have raised $111,407. That is 111,407. Wow. It's amazing. We're getting there. So folks, I sure am looking forward to when we can all be together again in person. But in the meantime, Stephen and I hope you had a great night with us here and that you enjoy the after party with DJ Casanova, live on screen in a few short minutes. Stay safe and well. Hey Stephen, the script says you're supposed to say thank you. How can you do that with a mouthful of cookies?
Let's all celebrate and have a good time.